And now, your tweets. So let's go to the first Twitter question. Okay, Louise Strecker, Bat Poet, asks, why do you think 12 Years a Slave wasn't named Best Picture by the three film critics organizations? Well, interesting observation, Louise. It did not win all the awards so far, but you know what? It's won a lot. It just dominated, among other pictures, the Golden Globe nominations, which came out today. You have a very different sort of Oscar races to the degree we give a damn about these things than we had other years. It was pretty clear by this point last year that Argo really had the freight behind it. It was clear the year before that The Artist, whatever one thought of that, was probably going to dominate at the Oscars just because of its domination on some of the other critics' organizations. This year it's a very different story, very interesting spread, and a lot of good pictures. 12 Years a Slave has gotten some major prizes. American Hustle, David O. Russell's film opening soon, also very good, won the New York Film Critics Association Best Picture Award. Gravity, Her, both pictures split the Best Picture Award at the LA Film Critics. So, already you're talking about a very different Oscar field than other years, and I'm glad for it. I'm glad that it hasn't settled yet. Okay, number two. Steve Carley asks, which newish director working today do you think has the most promise? Just putting together my torturously conceived best 10 of the year, which looks more like 20 or 30 pictures because it was a pretty good year. And one of the films on that list is going to be Fruitvale Station by Ryan Coogler. And that's a first-time feature filmmaker, I think, to watch. And, it's always tough to follow up a really good debut like Fruitvale Station and come up even halfway to that mark. But I hope he's got this stuff because it certainly seems like it based on Fruitvale Station. Ryan Coogler, that's my guy to watch. And number three, Dan Sutter asks, which is your favorite movie, Jesus? Max von Sydow, Jim Caviezel, Willem Dafoe, John Turturro, etc. Your favorite Hulk. I like that. Well, I'm not a praying man, except around layoff time. But I'd say my favorite movie, Jesus. What would you say? Jeffrey Hunter in King of Kings had the bluest eyes, and therefore the least maybe convincing of the Jesus. But Ted Neely hit the highest high notes certainly in Jesus Christ Superstar. But even though it was an oddly menacing sort of depiction of Jesus, I actually like Willem Dafoe's portrayal in the Scorsese film, The Last Temptation of Christ, which is a really interesting and very strong Scorsese film. It's kind of on my mind since Scorsese's got a new film out this season, The Wolf of Wall Street, which really has no Jesus figure of any type. But those are a couple of my favorite. But in terms of my favorite Hulk, Mark Ruffalo. That's it. We're done. There's no ins and outs with that one. It's Mark Ruffalo, and I'm still puzzled by why you think about Jesus and the Hulk in the same sentence. But it's a funny old world, and we're all different. Okay. Thanks very much for your tweets. We're going to do it again next week, and we'll be back for Real Thursdays next Thursday. Thanks. I'm Michael Phillips.